Welcome once again. In this video, we will study a difference between scalar and a vector quantity. So, scalar quantity are the quantity which can represent only by the magnitude of the quantity. Yes? For example, length. Yes? If we have to measure a length from this end to this end, we can directly measure this length. If this is a 30 centimeter, so this length is a 30 centimeter. So we can directly say that length of this particle or a material is 30 centimeter. So if we have to represent length, we require only magnitude. Yes, so we can represent length by only magnitude, so that length is a scalar quantity. Scalar quantity does not require the direction. Okay, so similar example for the scalar quantity are the length, area, time, mass. So all this quantity doesn't require the direction. Area is not required a dimension. Time is also not required dimension. Similarly, mass is also not required dimension. Yes, mass of any particle or any body is, we can say 10 kg, 20 kg. We are not saying a 10 kg in a downward direction or a 10 kg in upward direction. So we can directly say mass of the any object is a 10 kg or a unit kg, any magnitude. Yes, so we can directly say mass as a kg. So unit, we can directly represent that mass by the magnitude. So these are the scalar quantity. Opposite to the scalar quantity, vector quantities are a quantity which can represent only when there is a magnitude as well as the direction. Yeah? So if we have to represent a vector quantity, we require magnitude as well as direction. Yes, for example, displacement. Yes, so if we consider this example, displacement, if 10 centimeter or I displace 1 meter, yes, so you may say in which direction, where. So if we have to express the displacement, I have to say I displace 1 meter in a right direction. Yes, so we can identify the actual displacement concept. Yes, so similarly a velocity, so velocity also require a direction as well as magnitude. Same acceleration, and next is a force. So these are the vector quantity. So major difference between a scalar and a vector quantity are the scalar quantity required only magnitude and vector quantity require magnitude as well as direction. Next is idealization of the engineering problem. Yes, so if we have to solve engineering problems, so we have to consider a different assumption. Yes, so without that assumption, we cannot solve a engineering or mechanics problem, engineering mechanics problem. Yes, so for that we have to idealize the condition, or we have to assume the condition, so we can solve the practical problem, practical engineering problem. For that, so first assumption is body is a rigid. That is, if we consider a body, that body must be a rigid. If we have to study a body, for example, car. If we study a car, we have to consider that car as a rigid body. That is, if under the action of force, that car doesn't change its size and shape. Yeah? that's way only we can simplify our calculation. Next assumption is body can be treated as a continuum. Yes, so body can be treated as a continuum. It is a uniform shape or a uniform material. So continuum must be, body must be a continuum. Next is body is treated as a particle if dimension are smaller than the distance. Okay? So we have to treat a different a body as a particle if the displacement or a dimension of that particles are smaller than the distance or a displacement or a considered plane. For a smaller body, we can consider that body as a particle. As we discuss in a particle definition or an example for the particle, we can consider a earth also as a particle if we consider earth as compared to universe. Yes, so we have to treat a particle a body as a particle if dimension are smaller than the distance or a displacement or a reference plane. Yes? Now next assumption, if area of applied force is small as compared to the surface area of the body, then force must be treated as a point load. So for example, if we apply our weight on our floor area, that is a slab area, so as compared to the slab area, the dimension of my foot is negligible. So we can consider my whole mass is acted on a single point. Yes, so we can consider that whole mass of my body as a single point. Yes, so this is an assumption. So next assumption, weight of the body can be considered as a point load which is acting at the center of the body. Yes, if the body has a smaller dimension. So similar to previous assumption, if body has a smaller dimension, so we can consider its mass as a single point load. Yes, so for example for this, if a person is standing on a ladder, if there is a ladder, inclined ladder, and a single person is standing on a ladder, so as compared to the length of the ladder, surface or dimension of a person is smaller or negligible. So we can consider whole mass as the point load. Next assumption is support condition are idealized as a simple hinge fix etc. So different support condition are simplified. For example, in practical problem, if we consider a bridge, so or we consider the beam, okay? So beam is inserted in a column, so it has a fixed condition. So for a simplicity or in that fixed condition, we have to consider the lot of displacement in x direction, in y direction, or in a rotation direction. So for simplification, we can consider a beam as a simply supported beam. So example for this support idealization is a bridge girder. So the bridge girder is simply placed on a two bearing of that column. We are placing that beam on a column at a two point, but practically we are adding some adhesive to compact that beam with column. So we can neglect this compactness, we can neglect this joint, so we can directly consider that as a simply supported beam or a girder. So for the simplification, we can consider a join as a simple or a hinge or a fix. In practical condition, they may vary in minor condition. So these are the different basic quantity required for the study of engineering mechanics.